Hi everyone, this is Cass from Heal Consultancy, and we will be discussing frankincense and thyme essential oil. Are they effective against skin and breast cancer? Let's find out. Frankincense oil comes from the resin of the boswellia tree, of which there are many subtypes, and typically grow in the dry mountainous regions of India, East Africa, and the Middle East. Thymus vulgaris, known as garden thyme, is commonly used as a food seasoning, found around the Mediterranean and other regions of the world. The essential oil comes from the leaves and flowers. Both frankincense and thyme have been used for their medicinal benefits for over 1,000 years, but only recently have their anti-cancer properties been studied by scientists. A 2010 study tested 10 different essential oils against prostate, lung, and breast cancer cells in vitro, which means in a test tube. Thyme oil performed the best against all three, even at low concentrations, and was able to kill almost 97% of breast cancer cells. After reading this study, I realized the potential topical oil application could have against cancers which are close to the skin surface, such as breast and skin cancer. This in vitro study found thyme and sage essential oils were able to reduce the growth of skin cancer. This study, done on mice and rats, tested the anti-cancer effects of dry thyme in the diet as well as the essential oil in vitro. Both were effective. This picture shows what happened to cancer cells 9 days after a 2-minute exposure to thyme oil, which is the main component of thyme oil. There were 0 cancer colonies detected. They also found effect in mice, concluding, quote, "Our findings provide the first evidence of thyme oil's novel anti-tumor effects against oral squamous cell cancer in vivo, and may be efficacious against multiple cancers." This review documents various anti-cancer pathways and concludes, quote, "It is evident that thyme oil may be one of promising plant-derived cancer chemotherapeutic agents." A similar story with frankincense. Some examples are highlighted. In vivo studies, which means in living animals, are highlighted here. There is also a human case report. Left picture is a basal cell carcinoma of the arm, and on the right, 14 weeks after treatment with frankincense oil applied several times daily, resulting in complete resolution. The next picture is from the same person and study, but this was a basal cell carcinoma of the chest. The same topical treatment gave an 80% reduction after 4 months. No side effects reported. Another field of study which is relatively new is the influence compounds produced by plants can have on cancer stem cells, which conventional treatments may not be able to deal with. These stem cells may be responsible for tumor initiation, progression, spread, and recurrence. Frankincense and thyme essential oils can potentially target cancer stem cells. Essential oils are able to attack cancer through multiple pathways, including boosting our immune response and epigenetics, which means they can change which genes the cancer cell turns on or off. The studies mention at least 9 different anti-cancer pathways. This is important because if a cancer cell is attacked in many different ways all at the same time, and its usual ways of coping are interfered with, then it might just give up. Reviews of the current evidence have described their diverse anti-cancer ability as compelling, and their potential use in cancer therapy as very promising. The preclinical data is lining up nicely, and the only thing missing is the next step, which is clinical trials involving humans. We must remember that natural products cannot be patented, therefore funding such trials is limited and may never happen on any significant scale. There are a fair number of anecdotal reports to be found online, with some claiming remarkable results. Therefore, this video would not be complete without discussing how they are being used. Since there is no standardization in the studies and no human trials so far, this should be considered an experimental course of action. It may work, it may not. Buy your oils from a reputable company with good product reviews. Organic is best. Aim for 5% concentration, which is about 1 drop essential oil per milliliter of carrier oil. Make each blend separately and do a patch test, which means rub a small amount on your wrist and leave it for 24 hours to see if there is any adverse reaction. If not, apply each blend 1-2 times daily to the affected area. Rough cost of ingredients shown here. The range in cost is due to the numerous brands available, each with their own quality standards. As a comparison, the average cost of early stage breast cancer treatment per person in the USA is between $27,000 and $109,000. Important to note, there are many evidence-based diet and lifestyle changes one can make to reduce the symptoms or severity of most conditions, including cancer. To review this presentation in more detail, please visit healconsultancy.com/cancer. Please like, share, and subscribe if you found this video useful. It could potentially help a lot of people. Thanks for watching.